true.
Baptized, and that's when it happens. The Holy Spirit connects with us. When He connects
but God is fearless. But God is fearless. Life is going to happen. There are going to be trials and tribulations. There are going to be ups and downs. But the key about the soul being connected to God, when that happens, we have that but God is fearless. But God will give me peace. But God will handle the situation when I don't know how to handle the situation. So our spirit helps deal with knowing that we have an inner peace when we have our turmoils of life. Now, the doctor has ordered an x-ray and an MRI. That means he wants a deeper look of what's going on in our lives. Now, let's be honest. Okay, I hit it too fast, we just don't talk. Let's be honest. One thing that we all have in common when we take a look is pain. Each one of us in this building has dealt with pain. It can be pain with a disobedient child, bringing the church on all their lives, having them on the plays and skits, having them singing, the boys and women are entertaining, all they can have them dress nice, you know, so they feel like they want them to walk with God. And then they decide at 19, I don't need them for church. Yeah, that's pain. Now, some of us who have pain, a scale from 1 to 10, our pain is 5. You know, some of us. Some of us have pain as 8. I've been experiencing 11, so. So, you have the disobedient child. Next, we have the financial hardship. Just to get into my personal life, I was laid off. But I came to work. I was on time. I did would just walk in. I would walk in and sit down. No feelings whatsoever. All I knew that my right side of my mind said, trust God.
Amen.
Trust God. But you know the devil, that left side,
yeah,
came back. He sure did. I said, I can't sing in church. For all 90% of my life, I was either with my mom or I was somewhere where she was. That hurt the pitch of her voice. I can't sing a song. First of all, I can't sing. Second of all, when it's time to worship the Lord and we are to sing, I pinned it on her to have my pitch, right? So for a couple of months, I said, I can't sing here. I don't hear her voice. And then I realized that all things work for my good. That he's intentional. He never fails. And all of a sudden, I started getting my pitch.
Okay.
Isn't that amazing? She said, way over here. All of a sudden, I just start singing again. It hurts. The pain was real, guys. I'm not going to. The pain of my mother passing away way before her time, I thought. The pain was real. So, after dealing with the pain, I realized that my grace is sufficient for you. The creator of the universe is telling me that my grace is sufficient. The creator of the universe is telling me that for my power is made perfect in your weakness. So when I'm at my lowest point, he's at his highest point. So I kept coming to church, right? That's his grace. Now, did the pain go away? No. The pain is still there. I can tolerate it because of my faithfulness, because of me working in the kitchen, because of me coming to last meetings, because of me sitting down with another young person that's talking about me about education, about living right and being right while they're in school. Because I kept working in the ministry, that pain subsided. It didn't go away. It still, you saw, I'm about teared up right here with my daughter mentioned Anna. So the pain is still there. I just can't tolerate it because I have that spiritual connection. My soul is connected to God. So now, soul checkup. In your bags, there's a deep sheet paper that has a list of 9 questions. And it is the soul checkup for you. It's the soul checkup for you. We are on a time constraint. So I want to bring out, let's look at question 1. How often do you really read your Bible? Is it once a week? Twice a week? Though we want that connection with God, you have to go with it. And that's when you study his word. So the person asks, how often do you read your Bible? The next question, are you praying? We know prayer is our communication to God. So are you praying? Are you praying for your leaders? Are you praying for your pastor? Right? Are you praying for the man at the job? Are you praying for your other sister than in Christ? Because we're all sisters. Or are you looking at your sister? Are you talking about your sister? Are you waiting for your sister to have a bad moment to capitalize on her weakness? So we really should be praying for one another. You can look at a sister and tell that she is going through something. I mean, wear a makeup good. Look nice and good, right? Look nice and pretty in your hands, right? You can dress up, but you can look at a sister's eyes and tell that she needs prayer, right? And not always. She needs prayer. Even the sister that bumps you or step on your toe, or that you know is talking about, you can have something with your toe right now. They like to talk about you. So I pray for them too. The Bible tells us to pray for our enemies. So I pray for those who don't love me. I pray for those who love me. I pray because I like some of the ministries. I pray because I don't like some of the ministries. I pray that, okay, I didn't do this, but somebody in the leadership called this, so I'm going to give 100% because I know through my prayers and giving 100%, God is going to make right now. I am not. So all of us are tired. But guess what? I want to encourage you not to grow weary as you're working for the ministries around you. It's important to know that as you work for Christ, as you participate in different ministries around the church, that the Lord will give you strength and He will bless you with other aspects of His life. And on the flip side, when you think you're tired, think about the cross. Because He carried that cross. So we ask you to clean up after lunch. Don't be all tired if you get this at 8 o'clock. Think about the cross. Okay? Think about the cross. Think about that we should not grow weary while we're doing well and working. Now, after you take this assessment, and my original plan was to let you go through the assessment, so please take a moment when you get home and go through that assessment. We will find out if you do a real self-assessment that we all need surgery. We all need some help. We need some bitterness cut out of us. We need some envy cut out of us. I need to quit being jealous. Okay, I need to work with this information. Have some to make it help me. So, I have some contrasts I want to do, but I have a few young ladies that volunteer so willingly to help me. So I want does something for your soul. It does something for your soul. When you go to the hospital and visit the sick, when you take a little time for the widowers that are in our congregation, the men and the women, you spend a little time, it actually helps you out. It helps you out. I know some people, I'm not going to call them names, they don't want to go to the hospital because they don't want to get sick. I totally understand. I totally understand. But wash your hands. Right. And have faith and move on. Also, as a woman of God, I want to remind my sisters that are present today and remind my friends who have come in to visit that are not members of the church to remember that I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are the works, and my soul knoweth right as well. Stay active in the ministries of the Lord. That will help your soul.
Amen.
Work with different activities in the church. It will motivate your soul. Stay active in the ministries of the Lord. Pray and show love towards your sisters. I want to encourage you to encourage the following people.
I betrayed you, not once, but many times. Will you love me?
I have lost my way. Would you love me?
Yes.
And I have one more sister that I want you to encourage.
I am a single mother with three kids, and I am pregnant now. Will you love me?
Yes. So again, ladies, I want to encourage you to love your sister. And also, I have a prescription for the doctor that the young lady passed out. So does everyone have their package that was from Dr. Jesus? He has prescribed this for all of us, so please take your package out. Please take your package out. It's facilitated by the Hilltop Church of Christ Sisters. The instructions are to take one pill by mouth daily. Through this appointment, I want to make sure that you love. Hardship, I want you to love three times more. In bad times, love unconditionally.
Amen.
In brokenness, I need you to love more.
Amen.
In good times, love always.
Amen.
Love as much as needed.
Amen.
This prescription was given to you on today. We want you to fulfill this prescription for a lifetime. Because this is straight from Dr. God. And I want to thank you for coming. An opportunity to listen to me and how to encourage and to help our local souls. And please, ladies, remember for total fitness, you have to work on the body, you have to work on the mind, and then you work on the soul.
I